Yes, I'm leaving. Leaving. I'm home and gone.
Welcome back, Dreamers. I'm Zeke, and welcome to the Dream Green Show. This is week 15 of my AMD Trading Challenge, and it is a good one. In this video, I'm going to explain to you guys how to play the AMD and Xilinx merger news that's going on, and how can we use this news to possibly trade it to gain money in the coming weeks. But before we dive into it, this video is brought to you by Webull. Sign up now by clicking the link down in the description, deposit $100, and receive two free stocks valued up to $1,600. Once again, the link is down in the description. So AMD is reportedly in talks to acquire Xilinx in a deal that could top $30 billion. AMD, which has a market evaluation of over $100 billion after a huge run-up in shares this year, saw profits more than quadruple year over year last quarter. Well, after this year, AMD has a market evaluation of over $100 billion, and now they are in talks of acquiring Xilinx for around $30 billion. It could be a little more, it could be a little less. That news alone drove up the price of Xilinx over a little 13 or 14% in just one day. I'm going to show you that once we pull up the Robinhood portfolio. So AMD kind of traded sideways and took a little dip. So we're going to see if we could take this opportunity to swing trade AMD in order to capitalize on this news. So let me go ahead and pull up my position for AMD, and then we could dive into the news and figure out exactly what is Xilinx and why AMD might be trying to acquire them. So let's go ahead and pull up my Robinhood account. Here we are on my Robinhood account. AMD is at $83.06. Like I said, they took a little dip after they announced that they might be acquiring Xilinx. It is down $3.41. I currently own 51 shares of AMD, which is around $4,236.06. And my average cost is $37.04. And I am currently up $2,347.11, 124% on AMD. So this is one of my best performing stocks in my portfolio. Let's scroll down over the last couple of trades I took on AMD. Here we go. The market buy at $80.89, another market buy at $80.47, another one at $77.52, and another one at $79. So as you guys can see, I've been buying AMD at least one share every time AMD takes a dip. Right now, AMD looks like it's in a dip right now, so I might be buying AMD this week if I see it at a $80 price point again. I think I'm gonna go ahead and pick up another share of AMD. Okay, so let's scroll back up to where the market cap, that market cap is just under $100 billion right now at $97.56 billion. So just underneath the $100 billion market cap, but they were at $100 billion market cap just a couple weeks ago. Over the last month, they are up 4%. So this month alone, they are doing pretty good, pretty solid. So let's go ahead and dive into the market analysis to see how I'm going to play AMD, to show you guys how I might play AMD up in this upcoming weeks. And then we'll dive into some of the news to see if we can use that to help us trade AMD. All right, here we are. Xilinx is an American technology company that develops highly flexible and adaptive processing platforms. The company invented the field programmable gate array, programmable systems on chips in the adaptive compute acceleration platform. So obviously they have some type of technology that AMD wants that they could implement into their future GPUs or their future CPUs or their cloud server CPUs that they're using. So this is Xilinx website. Yes, they make accelerating cards, different CPUs, and it looks like they have some type of technology that AMD wants to implement into their own company. So this buy, this merger might actually be a great innovative way that AMD can produce amazing chips in the future to consistently outbeat Intel, because I know Intel is cooking up something strong to combat AMD chips, but it looks like AMD is trying to be very innovative right here by picking up technology from Xilinx. So let's go ahead and scroll over. This is on the thinkorswim. We are doing the market analysis. Let's scroll all the way back out on the 180 day chart. I have not drew out these lines over the last couple of weeks, but it still looks like they're holding true. Let's draw out this line right here, and then also this uptrend line that I drew out a couple weeks ago that is also holding true. So AMD is in an upward flag right now. It looks like if it comes down and break beneath this price point right here, it could pull all the way back to around the $73, $75 price point. But if it does trade inside of this little flag and breaks above, we could see AMD reaching all-time highs of around $95. Now, if AMD does acquire Xilinx, and then they would have to announce what are they planning to do with the technology, because a lot of investors don't want you to spend $30 billion on a company and not know exactly what you're going to use this company for. They want to know what are you going to use their technology for in your company in order to make your investors money in the future. So after AMD acquires Xilinx, if they even acquire them, if they acquire them, they're going to have to announce within a month or two what are they planning to do with the technology that they just picked up for $30 billion, because investors don't want to make it seem like it is a waste to spend $30 billion on what we don't know they're going to use this technology for. So if we zoom in on the 1 hour 20 day chart, it looks like it's bouncing off the 180 day simple moving average. So I expect over the next couple of days, if no news come out, AMD can trade inside of this flag right here over the next couple of days on a slight uptrend to around a profit of around 5%. If not, if everything else does go sideways, it could fall back down to its, I'm gonna draw a little support line right here. Bam, it could fall all the way back down to around $78. So if AMD do fall around $78, I plan on picking up a share if it do fall to that price point. And let's zoom back out on the 180 day. So yeah, looking at it on the 180 day as well, if it falls to around $78, $75, I will be picking up a share at $78, and if it falls to $75, I'll be picking up another share. But until then, I think it's gonna trade on this uptrend pattern until it eventually breaks out this flag. It's either gonna break up. If it does break up, I'm gonna buy, and if it breaks down, I'm going to wait until it pulls all the way back to around $78 to under $80, okay? If it breaks below, I'm gonna wait till it pulls to around $80, and then I'm gonna buy. If it breaks above, I'm gonna buy for a quick trade, let it ride all the way up to around $94, and then sell it for a quick profit on AMD. So yeah, guys, that is two ways that you could play AMD. You could either wait for it to pull back outside of that flag and fall all the way down to around underneath $80 and pick up some shares while it's on sale, or you could wait until it breaks above and it has a lot of momentum coming from the news, and then sell when it reaches a new all-time high. So those are two ways that I'm planning on playing AMD in the upcoming weeks. Make sure you do your own research, because when news like this comes out, the price moves very, very fast, and I'm going to try to keep up with it and let you guys know on the community tab. So make sure that you guys subscribe to this channel so you don't miss out on all the information that I give on my community tab on my YouTube page. So if you guys already own some AMD, comment down in the comment section, what are you planning on doing with your shares? Are you just going to hold on to them? Are you going to swing trade them? Are you going to sell them all? But let me know down in the comment section down below. And while you're down there, make sure you hit the thumbs up button. It helps out this channel more than you can even imagine. But other than that, I'm Zeke, bringing you the Dream Green Show, and I'm out. Peace.